in, a deep breath, stretch the arms. Let's bring the other leg into the chest, all the way in. And let the leg fall across the body to the other side. And again into the chest, lifting the leg for a little more intensity, a little flexibility. Now we're going to support ourselves coming up and facing the legs, and let's reach for the calves, the ankles, the feet, whatever is your particular level of flexibility, and hold it. And up, pulling the toe toward the calf, get a nice long stretch. The other leg. And facing front, with one leg extended. Let's bring the shoulders up and press down. And the ear to the shoulder, let your head feel heavy. Body and wrap the arms around the legs, around the back, sit back. And now sit tall, straighten the back. Once more, drop back. All the way back. And tall. And you are on your way to a beautiful sculpted body. See you next time. For the warm-up, we're going to use a small towel and put a little resistance, a little tension from side to side without squeezing the hands too tightly. So we're going to begin by lifting the head, tucking the hips, using the abdomen, and placing the head side to side. So it's ear to the shoulder and ear to the shoulder. Side and side. And again, last time. Now we're going to look to the side. Look to the side and shrug the shoulders. We want to warm up all the muscles, all the joints. So now we're going to change the movement to the center, to the top. And let's start using those legs too. So I want you to push and pull. We're going to change it slightly. Press it out, in and down. Press and pull and down. Again to the center, to the top. A few more. Now to the top, we're going to press and center. Press it back and center. Remember, you don't want to grip too tightly with the hand. Just pulling side to side. Take it down, bring the elbows forward and back and lift up. We're not pulling on the head. We're using this as an opportunity to separate the shoulder blades. Warm up the back. To the chest and to the back. Down and up. Deepen the lunge as you warm it up. Warm up the leg. To the top, reach it to the side. And center. Remember to tuck your hips on this. We don't want to arch the back. A little more. Deepen it and deepen it. The arms are in line with the ears, not in front of the head. Last time, to the top, to the center. And reach. We're going to change it now by doing a twisting movement. You might want to bring the arms closer together. Use the chest muscles, the pectoral muscles, warming them up. Twist, and twist, and twist. In and out, in and press. Let's use those legs, come on. Once more, as we did in the beginning, to the center and lift. A few more. Last variation, in and press and pull and push. Just a few. And we are warmed up and ready to go. Now that we're warmed up, we're going to proceed with the workout by working the pectoral muscles, the chest area. Make sure that you have something soft to cushion your knees. And some of you may want to do the extended version, like I will begin to do, and then some of you might begin with the modified version, depending on your fitness level. So let me remind you to use your abdomen and not sink in the middle. Your arms will be extended about shoulder width, and we want to go all the way down, just about to touch the floor with the chest, and then all the way up. Those of you that find that you're not keeping up with us, remember that this is something that builds. So you'll do a little in the beginning, and you'll do a lot later on. Trust me. So I'm going to begin with the more advanced version, which is on the toes, and some of you will begin on the knees. The choice is yours. Here we go. All the way down and up. Do squeeze your gluteal muscles and use the abdomen to support your back. All the way down and up. Using the chest. Well, this feels so good, I think I'll do a few more. If some of you feel like you've done about enough for now, then take a stretch to the back and then continue. But I want to make sure that I'm here for you when you're real strong. And down. Again, being very careful that your back is supported by your abdomen. I'm going to make a change. Come back for two. And now I'm going to do them in the modified version. And down for two. And here's that double pulse I was referring to, staying in the intensity for an extra count, so you have the opportunity to really work the muscle. This is not a bouncing movement. You're just staying low and almost holding it. Use your back. Now we're going to do three to the front. So it's one, push it up. Two, push it up. One to the back. Again, we're taking the chest all the way down. Your arms are about shoulder width, maybe a little more. All the way down. We're overloading those muscles, making them strong, warming up the chest, working the chest. One to the back, one to the front. Back and front. Again, make sure you have something soft, cushioned under your knees, it's very important. You don't want to be distracted from the main point of the exercise by our knees being sore. A few more. Let's take the last few to the front. Oh yeah. Use your abdomen, don't get sloppy as you get fatigued. You want to keep the form perfectly correct. Okay, last few. Last two. Last one. And stretch it to the back. Good job. We're working a circuit where we're working the pectoral muscles, the triceps, and then the biceps. So now grab your weights. We're going to work the triceps. And I want you to use weights that are heavy enough to challenge you. So you might need a few sets and decide which one is appropriate for a particular exercise. So here we go with the weights overhead. So take it down and press it up. Take it down and press it up. Now we have the elbows fairly close to the head. Dropping the weights all the way down and up. Now I want you to pay attention to other parts of your body as well. We're going to squeeze the gluteal muscles and hold in the abdomen with the knees bent. All the way down and up. Again, watch that your elbows are fairly close into your head. A few more. Now the elbows stay pretty much in the same place. Don't swing them. Alternate, take it down. Make sure to relax the hands. Don't grip those weights too tightly. All the way down, press it up. And as we did before, keep the weights slightly separated so that creates a little more challenge for you. Down and up. Okay, now we're going to change it slightly. Bring them down, put two weights in one arm, bring it up. The arm is next to the ear and we're bringing the weight towards the opposite shoulder. Check your form, make sure it's absolutely correct. Try that double poundage in one hand, it gets the job done. Keep the arm fairly close to the head, towards the opposite shoulder. And press. Let's take it to the other side, switch them. Same thing, work those triceps. And press. I'm placing my hand on my abdomen to remind me to use the abdominal muscles. A few more. Come on, all the way down towards that opposite shoulder. Okay, we're gonna bring it down, going to bring it down. Both weights up, and we're going to use that double pulse. So we're going to take two at the top, and down, two at the top. If you're feeling the fatigue, that's great. That's what we want to feel. We want to feel those muscles being overloaded, working hard. And the shoulders are pressed down, even though we're working with the arms overhead. The neck is long. And once more, let's alternate. Take it all the way down and up. Get those elbows in close to your face. Just a few more. We're going to pulse it up. Stay in the contraction, no release. Oh yeah. Overload those muscles, make them strong. We're going to define them, make them look great. And let's bring it down. And know that we've worked those triceps and we're going to do it again. Continuing with the biceps, I'd like to give you a few pointers. I'd like you to work with the elbows slightly in front of the hips and certainly with the arms in close to the body, not out here. So again, make sure that you're using heavy enough weights that challenge you. And here we go with the feet about shoulder width apart, the knees slightly bent, and palms facing the ceiling. Now you can also experiment with whether you want to have your thumbs under the weight or around the weights. Anything that challenges you, that gives you, feels like a little more control, is what we want. So you want to squeeze at the top. Get those biceps working. And squeeze. And alternate, same movement. Each arm, one at a time. Now we're going to face the palms in and keep going. We're going to hit that bicep from different angles. Kind of surprise it a little. I keep loosening my grip because it's important to not squeeze the weights too tightly. Check your gluteal muscles, make sure you're squeezing them. And change it. So we're going to twist at the top and then bring the palms facing each other. So it's a slight variation on the theme. Think bicep contracting and lengthening. Now we're going to change it with the palms facing the floor, so we're working into the forearms a little. Up and down. Squeeze and down. Make sure that your shoulders are back, your chest is lifted, your neck, your shoulders, everything is in its proper place. As we did from the beginning, but we're going to pulse twice at the top, stay in that contraction. Get that muscle contracted before you release. And let me remind you to go the full range of motion here, so you're all the way at the top and then push all the way at the bottom. We don't want to stop short in the range. Give that muscle its fullest work at. Same thing, palms facing each other. And down. Squeeze it short. And lengthen. Oh, glorious biceps. Change it slightly, twist it up so that the palms are facing the body, and then there's a small twist at the bottom. Remember, the knees are slightly soft. We don't ever want to lock the knees. We don't want to ever stress or overwork the joints to work the muscles. That makes sense, right? You bet. Okay, palms facing the floor. And I'm even finding a little energy to tap my toe because it needs to tap. Relax the hands, shoulders down. And let's alternate, last few. And we're going to get ready to work those pectoral muscles again because that's part of the repetition that's going to sculpt those muscles and make them quite beautiful. Last few. Get ready to go back down to the floor. We're going to work our second set of pectoral exercises. So this time we're going to use the weights. Last time we did the push-ups, this time we're going to use the weights. We're work them somewhat differently, but still get that jab done. So I'd like you to be on your back, being aware of the lower back pressed to the floor. The feet are about shoulder width apart. Here we go. So we're to the back and to the front. Very important that the lower back stays on the floor for this. You might want to cross one leg up to facilitate that. I'm going to keep both feet on the floor. The elbows stay slightly soft, slightly bent. And alternate. Think about the chest initiating the movement. The chest is what is making the arms move. Think about it in your mind's eye. It makes all the difference. Let me remind you to loosen the grip on the waist. Get ready to change. With the palms facing each other, down and in. Now, we're gonna do a variation on this. I'm gonna slow it down, middle to down. Now, when you get to the top, I want you to bring the pinkies together. Bring it in so we get that extra squeeze at the top. Middle, pinkies in. Check your lower back, make sure it's pressed down. Now you want to have the arms pretty much extended from the shoulders, not too high and not too low, just straight after the body. When you bring the arms down, we don't want to rest the arms on the floor because that's not nice, that's not in the rules. Remember at the top, we're turning the weights in and squeezing the chest muscles, the pectorals. Now we're going to change, so from the middle to the bottom, to the middle to the bottom. Check your lower back, real important that we not, that we have the lower back in the correct position. And let's just stay low at the bottom. So it's up and up. The elbows never touch the floor. Again, think chest. It's the chest that's initiating the movement. Last few. And how good are they? They're great. You're great. You're doing a great job. Overloading those muscles, sculpting them, making them look great. Last two, last one. Bring it up slowly. And we've done it. We're going to continue sculpting the triceps with our second set, so we'll do a little variation on the same thing. I'm going to stand to the side with my feet about shoulder width apart. The body is fairly erect, just slightly forward, and the elbows are back and as close to each other as possible. Here we go. So you reach and bring it in. I want you to lift and open the chest. The shoulders are down, the neck is long. Press. Let me remind you that the elbows don't swing, they stay in one place. Now let's take it back for two. Hold it and bring it in. There's that double pulse and opportunity to stay in the contractions to make the muscle